for the longest time, we used to specialize in thing, right? Just because the nature of how, right, computer hardware was being built, and you're an expert in this, and that's the only thing you can do, and that's the only thing that was possible, or you just look at a specific software and something.
So it's kind of in the past, you had these isolated fields like electronics and computer science, and then the market felt the need to have someone to bridge the gap between those two fields. And that's where the computer engineering comes.
And now this all comes back together, right? And it starts to tie in more and more interdisciplinary, right? And it's suddenly we need knowledge from all kinds of like areas coming together. So if you look at robotics, right, you look at the pure mechanics of how these things move, right? You look at the computer engineering part, right? What goes inside this one? And then you look at the whole software aspect. You look at the perception, right? The machine learning capabilities, what you need in the cloud, what you need on board, how does it like localize itself?
Even in cryptography or artificial intelligence, like I know that it's easier to see that it's mainly computer science and software. But again, those things need to run on a computer. Cryptography needs to be implemented in hardware. So we still need computer engineers to develop the hardware to run those algorithms, or even for artificial intelligence. In fact, Tesla cars, they have their artificial intelligence, the neural network done by hardware and FPGAs and things like that. So we still need a computer engineering background. And that's why it becomes blurry where things kind of go together.
And we've seen that with computers and smartphones, how that has all come together.
In terms of decisions, what you like, I think you should always follow what you love. Like if you like programming, just follow computer science programming. If you like circuits and electronics and a little bit of programming, computer engineering is probably a better fit. If you hate wires and oscilloscopes and all that stuff, like computer engineering is going to be painful.
That describes it really well. And in terms of undergrad curriculum, they're not that far apart that you probably couldn't switch like in your first year and say like, oh, that's not what I really expected, right? So especially at DU and most universities, that switch is not the hardest one. So the harder decision would be to make if you go for a master in either or, right? Because then the path would be a little bit further apart.
To add on what Kerstin is saying in terms of curriculum, it's probably easier to switch from a computer engineering to a computer science than the opposite. And that's just because how heavy the engineering degree is on math and physics. However, if during your computer science experience, your minors are math and physics, that transition becomes easier.
And I think it's very important, right, that you have both and that you also like are not just within that very narrow field, that you take a little bit of peek over it into other areas to be very successful at what you do.